Could you just tell me a bit about your characters in the film?
Sure. We're the Mattsons.
We're the Mattsons.
We're going to have a TV show. We're basically this young couple in the film who we're moving into our starter home, and we're really excited about it. And what happens is we move next door to somebody who's kind of comes from a completely different world than we do. It's just culturally different. He's more conservative. He's older. He's more strict, different set of morals and values, and he is not happy about us moving in next door.
And it's sort of, I think to him, it's sort of thrust in his face.
Yeah.
Both physically and just, you know, emotionally, I guess.
Yeah.
And the interesting thing about it is you might at first glance, when you see the trailer for the film, think Sam's just a bad guy, but you guys aren't perfect either in it. And there's a certain uncomfortableness in scenes, like the party scene when Sam comes over to your house. Does that, a lot of that come from Neil, from Neil's contributions to the script?
I don't know. I mean, I think Neil has a real strength for, you know, dissecting the human condition. I mean, I think he probably gravitates to that, you know, but not to take anything away from the Howard Corder script. I mean, you know, you had read previous drafts, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, I think it was all of it coming together. I mean, you're seeing Sam's performance, you're seeing a lot of the work that we had done as a cast talking through the issues, you're seeing Neil's directing and his rewrites and the original script, and it was a very, you know, one of the things I love about film is that it's so collaborative, and that's very true of this film. I mean, it really was a team effort to tell this story.
Was there room for improvisation or filling in backstory of your characters?
I think we had to, because we wanted to make, certainly for us, very clear, you know, one of the things that having an interracial couple, you're not trying to say this is the first time you've seen this on screen or how crazy is this, but so we had to be very clear, and there are little lines here and there that you may even miss the first time, but about the fact that we've been together, we've gone through this before, this is something we have dealt with, meaning racial tension, like, come on, we thought that was done with, we sort of dealt with that in college, so we didn't want it to feel like all of a sudden it's these two wide-eyed kids, like, what? People think this is strange?
I'm black? What do you mean?
I was colorblind. You know, because that's just been done so many times, so it was important for us to establish what history these characters had.
And Patrick, if I could just ask you about Watchmen, can you tell me a bit about how you approached playing Night Owl?
You mean Night Owl Lakeview Terrace?
He's got a little bit of that at times.
But we actually went straight from this to, actually, I think it was at an event for Lakeview when Carrie outed me.
It was a big industry secret, and I accidentally leaked it to the press.
Yeah, no, I had a great time. It was about, you know, 8 months in Canada, so we had a great time.
You seem a lot younger than the character in the graphic novel. Did they play
a few years? You know, okay, he's close to 40.
He's aging well.
35.